Everybody.
Hello, sis.
How are you tonight? I need to hear. How are you? Good, good. This is it. This is it, right? Clearly, it is the final night, but not the final episode of Proclamations of Hope. There is just one more proclamations, and that is the 20th episode, which will be done on Sabbath.
Indeed it is. My, Sister Fiona, what a thrilling 4 weeks it had been. Welcome to all our viewers, whether you're online or worshiping here under the tent. We welcome you. Already, there are over 250 devices already online, and the chat is already alive. It was our joy sharing and interacting with you.
Of course it was. We looked forward to sharing with our DDCs and our VIPs each night. Thank yous, your praise the Lord, your amens and your hallelujahs. It made much fun for the place to be such a fun place while learning about the gospel. It was a real pleasure having you, and we love you.
Yes, tonight, the last sermon for this week will be preached, and I am sure, Sister Fiona, I am positive that you have been blessed by all the messages from Fully Done's to When I See the Blood. Indeed, our lives have been changed, and we thank God for these proclamations.
Oh yes, we thank God for his goodness and his mercies toward us. Once again, we will present the man of God for the final night. I am sure it will be another engaging, Bible-backed, power-packed sermon. Tonight, we will receive an unexpected guest, even though we may not have invited him, but he will be coming.
Yes.
I am looking forward to hearing who this unexpected guest will be.
I am sure we are all looking forward. I am looking forward to hearing this message, Sister Fiona. How about you here? And those online. So as we prepare for tonight's message, let us invite the praise team to come and sing for us. Before they come, let us pray.
Okay, let us get into that attitude of prayer as we invite the presence of the Lord in this place. Father, we thank you. We thank you for your goodness and your mercies. We thank you for taking us safely through the day. And I pray now, God, that as we come to worship you, I pray that our worship will be in spirit and in truth. Bless each worshiper, whether here under the tent or online or in the vicinity of our hearing of our voices. I pray, Lord, that you will bless and that you will keep us. Bless the singers tonight as they come to bless our hearts. Bless all who will take place in this worship service as we tell you thanks. In Jesus' name I pray.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Troublesome times are here, filling men's hearts with fear. Freedom we all hold dear, now is at stake. Humbling your hearts to God, save from the chastening rod. Seek the way pilgrims trod, Christians are willing. Let's do that again. Troublesome times are here, filling men's hearts with fear. Freedom we all hold dear, now is at stake. Humbling your hearts to God, save from the chastening rod. Seek the way pilgrims trod, Christian away.
My Jesus is coming soon, morning or night. Many will meet their doom. Trumpet will
Glory road.
To my home, too near to my heavenly home, for I can't turn back again. Amen. My
worthwhile to look about now. Praise your Lord, sweet heaven in view. I'm so near to my heavenly home to turn back now. Oh, I'm so near to my home, too near to my heavenly home. For I can't turn back again. I've made my choice, but there is nothing worthwhile to look about now. Praise the Lord, sweet heaven in view. I'm so near to my heavenly home to turn back now. My home is in heaven, just waiting for me. And when I reach there, how happy I'll be. My home is in heaven, no rent to pay. My Jesus paid it all for me. My home is in heaven, oh yes, just waiting for me. Oh yes, and when I reach there, how happy I'll be. My home is in heaven, no rent to pay. For Jesus paid it all for me. Made up and I won't turn back, because I want to see my Jesus someday. Because I want to see my Jesus someday. I've got my mind made up, and I won't turn back. Because I want to see my Jesus someday. Praise the Lord, saints, praise the Lord in God's own way. Praise the Lord, saints, praise the Lord in God's own way. Persecution we must bear. The sweet and the victory. Oh, I say, press along, saints, press along in God's own way. Press along, saints, press along in God's own way. Persecution we must fear, trial and crosses in our way. On the attack, the battle, the sweet and the victory. For there is no satisfaction without salvation, S-A-L-V-A-T-I-O-N. My friend, for there is no satisfaction without salvation, S-A-L-V-A-T-I-O-N. Oh, shout it out now, shout it out. Lord and faith, S-A-L-V-A-T-I-O-N. Oh, shout it out,
shout it out.
Lord and fair, S-A-L-V-A-T-I-O-N. Yes, there is no satisfaction without salvation, S-A-L-V-A-T-I-O-N. No, there is no satisfaction without salvation, S-A-L-V-A-T-I-O-N. So shout it out. And praise the Lord. It is He who has brought you here. Let us stand together as we do our theme song. One more night. Just stand together.
Aren't you glad for the blessed hope in Jesus?
Yes.
Beautiful. Shall we bow heads of prayer? Divine Lord and our Father, this evening, Lord, we lift our hands to you. More and more through our life's experience and even through your words, we recognize that truly it is in Jesus that we live and move and have our being. And so, God, as we come this evening, we recognize that all the bounties that we enjoy, they are courtesy of Jesus. And so we are asking that through his merits, through his spilled blood, that he'll forgive us, that he'll absolve us from every defilement. We thank you so much for the blessings of the day, for journeying mercies, and the privilege to be here to be identified with the promulgation of the gospel. Your word admonishing us that we ought to be in obedience to your will. And so as we come this evening, obedient to you, aligning ourselves with your eternal will, we pray, Lord, that you will be with us, be it every participant, every worshiper, be it every visitor in a special way. We know there are many persons in foreign lands who are tuning in and even will tune in hereafter. We pray in a special way, Holy Spirit, that you who inspire the word, that you'll inspire their minds, that you'll imbue them, reveal the eternal realities to your people, and give them faith and obedience to yield unreservedly to you. We just want to thank you for the many who are making their minds up to serve you, to walk with you all the way. We pray, Lord, that you'll continue to dispatch your holy angels to encircle them, to administer to them, and more so, Holy Spirit, reveal more of your will to them. Tonight we pray for your manservant. We thank you for the way you have been using him night after night, and Sabbath after Sabbath. And tonight, as we come on this final night, we recognize, Lord, that he can do nothing without you. And so we pray for the empowerment of your Holy Spirit, that as he stand tonight at the lectern and as he open his mouth, that you, Holy Spirit, will imbue him, you'll speak through him, and you'll speak to your people, especially those who need to fall in love with you. We commit all things in your care, every besetment, every distraction, every spirit of dissension. We pray that you'll bind them with your omnipotent power, keep them at bay, so that even tonight, even those who are online, all of us, we can have a worshipful experience. And truly, someone will come to know you as Savior and Lord. We commit all things in your care. Reign supreme, we pray. Through not a name, but the conquering name of Jesus, we pray. Amen. Amen.
Good evening, everyone. You will notice I'm smiling, am I not? And can I tell you the good news? I belong to Jesus. How about you? I want to see the smiles on your faces too. Yes, I'm happy to see you. How about this side? Are you going to be smiling for us too? I am happy to see you all. And we must say thank you, God, for being such a grateful God that you are here with us even as we sit on the, or stand under this tent tonight. Can I tell you too that God is such a merciful God, that regardless of how we live, regardless of who we are, regardless of how big we feel, we are still subjected to Christ. And until then, we are nowhere, because Satan is there, he's waiting, but I'm sure nobody wants to be with him. So I welcome you in the presence of the Lord tonight. And I want to say I'm glad you all came to join us in our worship tonight. And I pray that as you would have left when you're ready to leave, you will allow that Sabbath coming. You will be under this tent again, and not just that Sabbath, but for all Sabbaths. And can I tell you, for those of you who have not yet trusted the Lord, I am still welcoming you. We're happy to have you. And we want you to look to Jesus and take the change. What do you say? Amen. Amen. So can I tell you, brethren, have yourselves a wonderful night. And we're looking forward to seeing you on Sabbath. What do you say? Amen, amen again. So it's amen, amen, and amen. And what does that say? We all agree. So have yourselves a wonderful evening. You're more than welcome for being here. And we're still looking forward to having you as long as we can. And I am just Miss Long, Sister Long, I have now become. What do you say? So when you see me, I don't want to hear Miss Long, I want to hear Sister Long. And for those who I do not know yet, when I see you, call to me, man. I'm say, where name, brother what? Sister what? I don't mean what. I hope your man say, I hope I'll become Sister Long too, or Brother Long too. All right? So I don't know where it goes. Have yourself a nice night, and God bless you all.
Together with God's wonderful people, I love the thrill that I feel when I get together with God's wonderful people, for it's so nice to see those happy faces, praising God in the heavenly places. I love the thrill that I feel when I get together with God's wonderful people. I keep falling in love with Him. Sweeter and sweeter as the days go by. Oh, what a joy between my Lord and I. Keep falling in love with Him over and over and over and over again. He keep loving and forgiving me over and over and over and over again. He keep loving and forgiving me over and over and over and over again. He gets sweeter and sweeter as the days go by. Forgiving me over and over and over and over again.
Amen. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Good evening, everybody. God is good and all the time. If you're happy and blessed, say praise the Lord. If God is worthy to be praised, come on and shout the hallelujah. I want to welcome all of you to this, the final night of Proclamations 3. We are happy to be in the house of God in this Canvas Cathedral to lift up the name of Jesus, the only name that can bring us salvation. Amen. I want to say special welcome, especially to our visiting friends. If you are visiting online, type the letter V. It's not for vagabond. What is it for? Visitors. Do I have a first-time visitor for the last night tonight? Raise your hand if it's your first time and you are not a member of the Seventh-day Adventist Church. On a late bad, but clap them still, everybody. I invite them to come forward. I'd like to present something to each of them. All right, please come along. I have a gift for each of you, and the one down there, welcome to you. Those who invited out folks online, to indicate in the chats the number of persons you've invited. All right, praise the Lord. Put your hands together for this one. To all that coming out in a bundle. Here you go, sir. Ma'am, here you go, sir. Put your hands together for her. That's another first time visit. Oh, Sister Long, you have your first time visitor tonight. Tell her next time don't take so long. Not because she knows Sister Long. Amen. Come along. I have something for you too. Please put your hands together for him. Don't be shy. We are happy to have you with us. Good evening. Put your hands together, man. Let our visitors feel really welcome. Do I have a repeated visitor? And you have never received a gift from me. I've taken care of you, haven't I? Now, I'm going to ask the tech folks to give a gift to our visiting friends online. And also, we want to acknowledge a few of those who are visiting online. We have Cheryl Russell, and we also have Donna Young and Merle Perry, Patricia Waite and Elvie Boot, and Jasmine Jemis Ferguson, and Angela Green, and Owen Senior Jones, and Karen Rattigan, and a number of others. We also want to acknowledge the folks tuning in over there with Brother Arnold Murray and the Pierce in Ewerton. So all the folks in Ewerton, we say blessings to you, and we pray that as the word of God goes forth, you will respond to it positively. Please put your hands together for the folks at the satellite location in Ewerton. And we welcome all of our friends from the various conferences across Jamaica. Please indicate in the chats which conference you are tuning in from. It's the last night, and therefore we invite you to ensure that you carry out your DDC work well. Engage your friends and family and neighbors and share the link. Put it on your statuses so that someone might hear the word of God tonight. Because faith comes by hearing, and hearing by the what? The word of God. And when I come back later on, I'm going to show you just how the work of the digital disciples for Christ have been doing effective things, not just here in Jamaica, but also in other parts of the world. Don't take it for granted what you can accomplish when you share the link or invitation with someone. Remember, now it's the last night, but it's not the last day, God's willing, because tomorrow we rest, but then Sabbath at 9 a.m. we'll be here again, and then we will wrap up the program. We look forward to having all of you with us, and I also look forward to seeing you later on. When we look at the subject, you didn't invite me, but I'm coming over. See you later.
There is color. Shall we praise the Lord? If you believe it is a glorious day, it will be. Let me give God the glory. Has God been good to you? Has God been good to you, church? Has God been good to you in your health? Has God been good to you in your finances? Glory be to God. That's what I want to hear. Because if God has been good to you in your health and also in your finances, tonight is the last night of Proclamation of Hope Gospel Series. And I'm sure that if God has been good to you, it is time for each and every one of us, those under the tent and those online, I'm sure that you're willing to give back to the Lord tonight. What do you say? Yes, you can give back because you know how these things operate. Some outstanding costs, but you can help us to defray them. What do you say? God has been a wonderful God to us through this journey. As our ushers come forward, let us dig deep in our pockets. And those online, you know what to do. The information is right there before you. Let us pray. As we ask God blessing, eternal God and our Father, from the inception of time, you are a giver. You give us life. You give us hope, mighty God. Most of all, you give us your Son, Jesus Christ, to shed his efficacious blood and Calvary cross for humanity. And tonight, mighty God, I hope we can find it inside to give back to you. Help us, dear God, not to close up our bowels of compassion, but we will be willing in giving back something tangible to you tonight, in Jesus' name.
Pressed down, shake it together, run it over again, and it will come back to you when you give the gift to the Lord.
come back to you. Good measure, press down, shake it together and run it over again. And it will come back to you. When you give to the Lord. Give, and it will come back to you. Good measure, press down, shake it together and run it over. Give, and it will come back to you. When you give to the Lord. Give, and it will come back to you. Good measure, press down, shake it together and run it over. Give, and it will come back to you. When you give to the Lord.
The answer was given to the question, is God has been good to you? And the answer was yes, God is good. We're here to lift up Jesus. We're here to surrender our will to Him. This moment, my brothers and sisters, visiting friends, those who are online, I crave your attention as you join with me in talk to the great God above. Let us pray. Great eternal God, marvelous are thy works. We come this moment in the name of Jesus Christ, your Son, the one who shed his blood on Calvary's cross for our sins. We come to say thanks to you. We come, O God, to lift up your name. But I'm going to ask you first, Lord, please, wash me, cleanse me, make me clean, as I do petition the throne of grace and mercy towards your people. Lord, in your words it says, if iniquity has found in my heart, then my prayer will be of none avail. So I ask you to wash me within and without at this time. We are here in this community of Grey Field. Your people are here. They are listening. But, oh God, they fail to accept and to surrender their hearts to you. But Lord, you are such a loving and merciful Savior. I just ask you at this time, be merciful unto them. And to help your people, O God, that even though this is the last night of this effort, they will surrender. Someone will surrender and come to glorify you. Be with your people everywhere. Those who are online, thou knowest them, Lord. Some are near, some are far, but thou knowest everyone. I just ask you, Lord, to be merciful and to help those who have not yet surrendered to you, that they will do so as they listen. Your manservant, O God, who you have been using night after night, completing the 4 weeks away from Sabbath, you use him. We are seeing people surrender, people baptized because of the Holy Spirit work upon their hearts, because your manservant has pleaded with them. Tonight, dear God, there is no different. We know you have the same power as you have in the past to use him tonight. May you cover him. May you stand beside him, behind him, and before him, that when he shall open his mouth, every word that come forth will be from your Holy Spirit. Oh God, take control of the hearts and the mind of every one of us who are under this tent and those who are in the hearing of my voice. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen.
Praise the Lord. Tonight I stand here to introduce a friend. You know, this man is a preacher, he is a counselor, he is a teacher, he is a motivator, he is a helper. And most of the time, you might come in the house of the Lord when this man is in the pulpit, and you decide that you're gonna rock back in your seat. This man caused you to come on the edge of your seat. Another time you say, okay, I'm gonna sit. This man make you stand to your feet. Another time you say, I'm gonna sit and keep my mouth closed. This man let you speak. I speak of no other than Pastor Jermaine Johnson. My friend, let me tell you something. This man has been doing a lot of good work over 4 weeks. Tonight is the last night. Tonight is the night when you should not go away without taking heed from the word of God. Hear the man as he come. But before he comes to you with the living word, the praise team will come and give you the song of praise.
I want to ask you to stand. I want to ask you to stand, everyone. Please stand. Oh Jesus, oh Jesus, oh I love calling. Oh, I said Jesus,
Jesus,
oh Jesus,
Jesus,
how I love,
how I love to call in your name.
Oh Jesus,
Jesus,
sweet Jesus,
Jesus,
every day. Let's do it again. I said Jesus,
Jesus,
oh Jesus,
Jesus,
oh I love,
how I love,
I love
calling your name.
Oh Jesus,
Jesus,
sweet Jesus,
Jesus, every day, your name is the same. Jesus,
oh I love,
how I love
your name is the same.
I remember the time when I felt so all alone. You see, all I had to do is call. Sometimes it was in the morning, sometimes late at night. But when I get off my knees, everything was all right. Oh, 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 Jesus.
Jesus.
Oh, Jesus.
Jesus.
Oh, I love.
How I love.
I love to
call in your name.
Jesus,
my Jesus,
oh Jesus,
sweet Jesus,
oh how I love,
how I love,
calling your name.
Somebody bless the name of Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Somebody magnify the name of Jesus. Come on, somebody shout the name above every other name. Give him the highest praise. God is good, and all the time, blessed be the name of the Lord. You may be seated in the presence of the Lord. Let's turn to your neighbor and say, it's good to see your face in the place. Give them a big grin. If you have indentures, be careful. But smile with them now. Come on now. All right, so having given the smile now, tell your neighbor that God loves you. He really does. And so do I. Give your neighbor a hug now. Praise the name of the Lord. Praise the Lord. For those who are tuning in online, the over 1.6 thousand devices, that's over 1,600 devices. Some of them have entire families watching. To those tuning in at our satellite location, Brother Arnold Murray and the Pierce and the boombox over there in Yeovilton, St. Catherine, and wherever you're tuning in from, here's your big hug and a smile. We welcome all of you tonight. Welcome back, Evangelist Bartley and company. We're glad to have you. Yes, you guys are honorary members. You are keeping up your district membership. Put your hands together for them. Good to have them with us one more time. Thank you very much, Elder Staple, for your words of introduction, and praise team for the wonderful song of meditation. I also want to acknowledge Pastor John Honore over there in the U.S. and Elder Jocelyn, we know that you're tuning in, invited out her pastor. It is the ultimate night. And then tomorrow we rest, and then we come back when? On Sabbath at 9 o'clock as we wind down Proclamations of Hope 3. And I know some of you are feeling sad, but listen, there's a time and place for everything. On Sabbath we'll look at the subject, No Bandula Business. And the following week will be, the following Sabbath, we will be convocating as a district at Moneague. We'll be receiving the new believers, and we'll be rejoicing in the Lord, and we'll be looking at the subject, red flags. So make sure that you tune in for that extended Sabbath. So though you might miss us when we close on Sabbath for the nightly programs, you can continue to tune in on a Sabbathly basis for our streams. And I will be presenting that additional message on the 6th of April from Moneague Church, starting at 9 a.m. So do bear that in mind. Brothers and sisters, I've been saying to you that we cannot take for granted what it is that we do here and the impact it has, not only on those in our immediate surroundings, but those who tune in internationally. I was home this morning when a colleague of mine, Dr. Ferran, have sent me a message from the United States, a link actually, of a post made by the South Atlantic Conference in the United States. And this is what the post read. On Sabbath, March 16, 2024, Elder, which is a pastor, sometimes they refer to the pastors as Elder. This particular person is a pastor. Elder William L. Winston, former president of South Atlantic Conference and interim pastor of New Covenant SDA Church, not intern, interim, is about to take up leadership there in Savannah, Georgia, baptized 6 precious souls. One of those baptized was Mealy Brown. Mealy attended virtually as Evangelist Jermaine Johnson. I don't know if you know that guy. Evangelist Jermaine Johnson of the North Jamaica Conference conducted a series of meetings. At the end of the series, Pastor doesn't know that it is not over as yet. At the end of the series, but he was referring to the end up until that point, Mealy expressed her desire to be baptized. Evangelist Johnson contacted Elder Winston, informing him that she would attend church desiring to be baptized. As Elder Winston prepared to baptize 5 candidates, he extended an invitation to others, and Mealy came forward. Upon hearing her name, he knew that this was the young lady that Evangelist Johnson had informed him to look out for. Having already attended the online meetings and expressing her desire to be baptized, she joined the other 5 candidates and went into the watery grave along with them. On this day, Elder Winston and went into the watery grave. On this day, Winston also performed 2 baby blessings. New Covenant just happens to be the church that was built under Elder Winston's pastoral leadership in Savannah. And there we have some photos that they posted. Put your hands together and bless the Lord for the spreading of the word. So when we say to folks online that if you are serious about your salvation, you can go ahead and click that link and fill in the details. We can arrange for you to be baptized wherever you are. Just indicate your decision for Christ. If you're near, we prefer to do it right here. But if not, we can make arrangements any part of the world, because the Seventh-day Adventist Church movement is a worldwide church. Somebody say amen. And so we thank God. And I know Sister Mealy is watching. She doesn't miss a night. She said to me the other night, this morning, she said, Pastor, I'm going to miss the series. And if we have any studies for new believers. Now, on a Tuesday evening, we have started what we refer to as weekly Bible studies with Pastor JJ. And the Zoom link information and all, I'm hoping the tech team could locate that. Well, I forgot to put it in the slide, but we'll share it on the weekend. We paused it for the duration of the crusade, but we will resume it the second Tuesday in April, not this Tuesday, but the following one. And it's on Zoom, so look out on our Facebook page, on our Instagram page, Moneague Adventist Online, and you will find the flyer there, which we will also repost later on for you to go and get the Zoom link information so that you can join our weekly Bible study. Somebody say amen. On the weekend, we will be having another charity hub distribution as we spread the love of Jesus in tangible ways. And nearly 100 care packages have been put together from the generous donations of persons locally and abroad. And we'll be distributing those to our teams from the different churches to distribute not only to persons in the church who have needs, but persons in the community who are not persons of the church as yet, we hope, who also have needs. Somebody say praise the Lord, because we care about the needs of people. Now finally, as I prepare for the word, some folks have been asking Sister Johnson what it is they can do for the series, how they can they assist us to carry on this international ministry coming right here out of nice Moneague. And so we have a wish list. There's items that you can choose from. If you want to donate something, you can choose something from the list and donate it, or you can reach out to us if you prefer to send the funds and have us acquire it so that we can continue to preach the gospel all over the world. Somebody say amen. And remember that as we come out this Sabbath, walk with your special gifts, your pledges, your special love donations towards Proclamations of Hope, so that when we close the program Saturday evening and we come to take down the tent and to pack up the equipment and also in the morning, all of God's bills can be settled. Somebody say praise the Lord. So I'll be walking with more, and I invite you to walk with more. And for those overseas, like some of you have been doing, if you prefer to send via remittance, you can indicate. If you are based in the States, you can always use Zelle, and the tech team might show them that information just now. And we thank you for your constant support, your prayers, your presence, and your gifts to the Lord's cause. And you can rest assured that whatever you give goes towards the cause of God. We are serious about the business of God. So as we continue tonight, Proclamation number 19, you didn't invite me, but I'm coming over. Let us look at our key text before we pray. Luke 11 verse 28, let's read it everybody. Blessed are they who hear the word of God and obey it. If you don't act upon it, Sister Kenya, it does nothing for you. Obedience is important. John 10, 27 and 28 says what? My sheep hear my voice and I know them, and I give to them what? Everlasting, eternal life, and they shall never perish, neither shall anyone snatch them out of my hand. Acts 5:32 says, and we are what? Is witnesses to these things, and so also is whom? The Holy Spirit, whom God has given to those who do what, church? Obey him. The other night I showed you that the Holy Spirit will be given to those who are willing to obey God. Somebody say amen. Because when he, the Spirit of truth, is come, the Bible says in John 16 that he will what? Guide you into what? Finish it. All truth, not part truth, but the full truth. Somebody said nothing but the truth. So the Holy Ghost is manifested in obedience to the will of God. So the more Holy Ghost you have, is the more obedience that you must have. Come on, somebody. You can't have the Holy Ghost and you are unholy most. You can't have the Holy Spirit and violate the commandments of God, because the Spirit of God will only lead you to the truth, and the truth shall set you free. Amen, somebody. Give me a little more monitor as we get ready tonight. The Bible says, woe unto the pastors then that scatter my sheep, that lead them astray. Because if you believe that your only problem are people who are outrightly in sin, the Bible shows us that Satan has false prophets, false preachers who are going to lead many people to hell. Can you imagine that you end up in hell and yet you went to church all your life? A committed member. And when you're reaching hell, you're down there with Natty Morgan, Gunman, and Bin Laden. All of them, the bad people there. And you're good church people, 20 years you got church. And when you say, God, what kind of false one? They say, I pull off for me. God said, depart, I never knew you. You who practice what? Lawlessness. If in judgment people will be rejected on the basis of lawlessness, Mr. Law Enforcement Officer, the law of God is still standing. Yes. I cannot but repeat these things. You didn't invite me, but I'm coming over. Bow your heads with me. Everlasting Father, as I stand here tonight once more as an earthen vessel to declare your words, I pray that you will cleanse me and fill me with the Holy Spirit and with the glorious gospel of Jesus Christ your Son, that the excellence of the glory may be of you and not of me. I pray, O God, that you will cordon off every heart here tonight for your glory. Prepare us to receive your words and to respond to them affirmatively. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. We jump over there to the book of Daniel. In Daniel chapter 1, as I demonstrated about 2 weeks back, Brother Graham, when they were taken captives from Judah, the young men, those who were still in the prime of their lives, were brought before the king for an assessment. It wasn't pep. It was a CSEC. It was a scholarly assessment to find out what they were made out of. And the Bible says that there were four young men who came to Babylon, and they stood out among the rest. Not just the rest of their countrymen, but the rest of even those in Babylon. And it caused many to be envious. The Bible says, as for these four young men, God gave them knowledge and skill in all literature and wisdom. They never dance. And Daniel, there goes one of them, had understanding in what, everybody? All visions and dreams. And at the end of it all, you can go through in your time, Daniel, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, the king found them, according to chapter 1, to be how many times? 10 times wiser than all of the isle of this and isle of that man them. All the necromancers, the magicians, the Chaldeans, the soothsayers, the Obia men. Daniel and his companions, not because they were practicing witchcraft, but because the wise God, the all-wise God of heaven, blessed them with wisdom. It doesn't get any better than that. Then we looked at chapter 2 of Daniel, setting the foundation. And in chapter 2 of Daniel, what happened, somebody? Daniel almost lost his life. Because despite knowing that Daniel and his companions were 10 times wiser than all the wise men of Babylon, when Nebuchadnezzar had the dream of the image with the head of what? Gold. And the chest and the arms of what? Silver. And the thighs of what, somebody? Come on now, bronze. And the feet, the legs of what? The legs of iron, and the feet iron mixed with clay. He never sent for Daniel and his companions. He sent for the ones that were 10 times less wise. Come on, somebody. But sometimes the otherwise elder, sometimes God has to set the righteous aside to expose the wicked. But it was only when the death wish went forth, when they couldn't interpret, when they couldn't tell the king his dream and what it means, that, and they started to die, that they sent for a man. Who did they send for? They sent for Daniel. As a matter of fact, they didn't send for Daniel to come and interpret. They sent to kill him. And when Daniel asked, what's the urgency? He asked the man who was in charge of the death sentence, please allow me to talk with the king, to get some time, and I will tell the king the meaning of the dream. Not only the meaning, I will tell him what he dreamt and what it meant. And at the end of it, Nebuchadnezzar glorified the king of heaven. But intriguingly, when we go to chapter 3, Nebuchadnezzar did something to defy the dream of chapter 2. He made an image of 100% gold. So, well, listen, what was Nebuchadnezzar doing, Sister Molly? Nebuchadnezzar was flying up in God's face. Nebuchadnezzar was trying to rewrite the course of history that God had set into motion. Because as I've demonstrated to you, the head of gold represents what? Babylon. And after that, the Medes and the Persians. And after that, Greece. And after that, Rome. And after that, Roman in its papal state and the divided nations of Europe. The Bible has set the course so well that some skeptics thought the book of Daniel was written after the fact. But God knows the past, the present, and the future. So God knew it before it took place. Somebody say amen. Amen. So Nebuchadnezzar said, hey God, I think you made a mistake. You have said that I am just the head of gold, but I'm going to show you my version of how this is going to work out. I am not only the head of gold, but I am also the breasts and the hands, arms of gold. I am the thigh of gold. I am the legs of gold. And if you take me down gold yet, I'm going to be the feet mixed with gold, with gold. I'm divided with gold. And he said, I am going to call everybody to bow down to it. And when you hear the sound of the music, all of the jump and them start to knock, and the band start to play, every man must bow down and worship the image. And that's why Granny said, Anna, every open will knock your feet dance. Sometimes when the devil is getting ready to deceive people, a whole heap of nice in there. some places you go, nice nothing there, but not truth not there in there. Can I talk to somebody tonight? And some of you say, yes, me love the nice man, me not like when church was so. I am not saying that church is so. When you come to church, the Bible says you must enter his gates with what? Thanksgiving in your hearts, and his courts with what? Praise God. Sometimes in their church, and your face long like God has done you something wrong. But there's a difference with being ebullient as you worship the Lord and just a jump up and roll and make nice. I'm not truth, not in there. So Granny said that every open when knock, you feel dance. Am I talking truth to somebody tonight? So then because I said, play the music, drum like Lego bees. But because Daniel's companions were faithful men of God, Daniel was not involved in this here. The boy said, we will not bow. And they reported it to the king. And the question tonight, although I'm not dwelling on it, I'm getting to my message. How, if they were bowing, how them know said the boys they never did a bow? Let me tell you something. A trap then they set up for the boy. People will set up trap for you. When you're walking with Jesus, some will entrap you and every move you make them a watch you. But when the Lord watches over you, let them keep on watching because you are covered under the protection of the Most High God. Somebody say hallelujah. So when the boys never bowed, they took them to Nebuchadnezzar, and Nebuchadnezzar knew that these were the same boys whom with Daniel interpreted his dream, and he had the audacity to threaten them to defy the same God who gave him the omen and his meaning. And so when he said that, he said, I'm going to throw you in the fire and let me see which God of yours will deliver. In other words, God, you caught me in a soft spot when you sent Daniel and these boys the last time with the meaning of the dream, but I'm going to show you why they call me the Babylonian king, the world power, the true dandada. And he threw them in the fire. The fire was so hot that even the men who tossed them in the fire dropped dead. But when Nebuchadnezzar looked in the fire, he saw four men in the fire. He sent for the lawyer same time and said, what did we not throw three men in the fire? And how comes I see four? And he said, the fourth one is like the Son of God. Can I talk to the church? Some people go on like they don't know that there's a King of Kings and a Lord of Lords. All them rejecting the call to salvation. All them flying up in the face of the preacher. All them rejecting the truth of the Bible. When judgment come and trouble take you and pick the short fit you, you shall remember that the Son of God is real. Nobody have to identify the fourth man, because Nebuchadnezzar knows say him exists long time. Yes.
That's right.
In a Daniel, touch your neighbor, say no done. So God delivered the boys out of the fire. No barbecue shall drop me, shall cannot bend. Now in chapter 4, notice how Daniel is building up no evangelist signs. Nebuchadnezzar had another dream. And this time, God showed him that, listen, Nebuchadnezzar, you are a big tree. But he never knows a small axe for a big tree. And a small axe, yeah, for a big tree. Can you imagine big axe like God axe? So he said, Nebuchadnezzar, you are a big tree. And when you read chapter 4, it described in the dream how we saw the birds of the air and the beasts of the field and people from all over the world coming under the tree for shelter and to enjoy its many leaves for shelter and its many fruits for food. And when it troubled him, he sent for Daniel. He sent for Daniel because he said, Daniel, I know that you are a wise man and you can interpret the dream. And the Bible tells us that Nebuchadnezzar brought him in. And when Daniel came, Daniel told him that you are this tree. He saw that the tree was cut down. And when it was cut down, a stump was left in the ground. And that he went to nyam grass like wild beasts. Come on, somebody. Humble yourself in the presence of God before your nyam grass. So Daniel told the king that what it meant, God was going to take the kingdom out of your hand. But he's going to do it for 7 times or 7 years until you learn how to acknowledge the Most High God of heaven. And when Daniel said it to him, the Bible says that Nebuchadnezzar took things for granted. Because Daniel said to him when you go to the chapter, but if you humble yourself and repent of your sins and iniquities and stop oppressing the poor, God might just show favor to you and prosper your kingdom. But so it looked like in the interim, Brother Howard, he humbled himself. But 1 year later, the Bible says in verse 28, all this came upon Nebuchadnezzar. At the end of 12 months, you see what I want to say, brethren? Sometimes the thing said, God, now make no move. But long run, short catch. At the end of 12 months, he was walking about the royal palace of Babylon. Put your plate in the air. So Nebuchadnezzar stepped up big and bossy. And the king spoke, saying, when you look at Babylon, hearing, is not this great Babylon that I have built for a royal dwelling by my mighty power and for the honor of my majesty? Why the king cockati? This king feels as if he's a king of kings indeed. Notice the word for my, the I and I, like Satan when he got kicked from the sky. And the Bible says, while the word was still in the king's mouth, him not finished talking yet, Brother Henry, a voice fell from heaven. And the Bible says, King Nebuchadnezzar, to you it is spoken, the kingdom has departed from you, and they shall drive you from men, and your dwelling shall be with the beast of the field. They shall make you eat grass like oxen, and 7 times or years shall pass over you until you know that the Most High rules in the kingdom of men and gives it to one whomever he chooses. Are you following what's happening here? God has already showed in chapter 2 that after Babylon, another kingdom inferior, then another kingdom, then another kingdom, then several kingdoms. So Nebuchadnezzar was carrying belly or a grudge against God for telling him that, listen man, it doesn't matter how your life nice now, expiration the planet, you must learn to humble yourself. Now you might be in your prime, but very soon you shall be prime not. Now is the time that you feel like you're young and you have all the days in your life to jump up and down and reject the Lord, but there's an expiration date here tonight, and when your time expires, no man can stop you from going down, because when God draw the line, you cannot cross it. That very hour. So you vex Nebuchadnezzar, because I've told you that after you, another kingdom is going to come. So you are saying to me, God, you're not going to take away this from my genealogy. This kingdom will be Babylon forever. Babylon, Babylon, Babylon. But apparently he never remembered that Babylon is falling. That very hour, the word was fulfilled concerning Nebuchadnezzar. He was driven from men and ate grass like oxen. His body was wet and drenched with the dew of heaven, till his hair had grown like eagle's feathers and his nails like bird claws. You hear that, brethren? And at the end of the time, I, Nebuchadnezzar, hear Nebuchadnezzar's testimony now, lifted my eyes to heaven, and my understanding returned to me. And I blessed the Most High and praised and honored him who lives forever. For his dominion is an everlasting dominion, and his kingdom is from generation to generation. All the inhabitants of the earth are reputed as nothing. He does according to his will in the army of heaven and among the inhabitants of the earth. No one can restrain his hand or say to him, what have you done? I said, Nebuchadnezzar had to name grass before learning how to humble himself. Some of us, like Nebuchadnezzar, we feel high and lifted up. Every day God calling us to repent. But we look upon the house and say, look what I have built. You look upon the bar and say, look what I have built. You look upon the relationship where they are going nowhere and say, look what I have built. You look upon your degree and your money and say, look what I have built. But God wants to remind somebody tonight that he is the one who sets up men and takes them down. And they climb. I said, the higher the monkey climb, is the more him expose. Humble yourself. Yes, sir. In the presence of God. Do you notice the forbearance of God? God sent the judgment, and yet God never executed it until 12 months. What do you think God was doing? Meeting with the lawyers to ensure that all of Nebuchadnezzar's legal rights were intact and he was not being violated constitutionally? No! God is his own judge. He doesn't answer to anybody. The 12-month period then was meant for Nebuchadnezzar to heed the warning Daniel gave him when he said, if you repent and turn from your wicked ways, the Lord might just have mercy upon you. So sometimes the preacher tells you to repent, and because everything seems normal in your life, you feel like, say, how will Pastor Johnson did that talk about? God is not going to make his good people and destroy them. I know that God loves me, and he knows that I love him too, and when I'm ready, I'm going to come. God, I'm on my way. Just give me a little time. Don't fool yourself. Don't fool yourself. So look at Nebuchadnezzar. Nebuchadnezzar became a servant of God when God humbled him after all those experiences. But watch out now. You didn't invite me, but I'm still coming over. You see, RSVP is a very important term in the world. It is the French for répondre s'il vous plaît, which simply means please respond. When you get invitations, therefore, to important functions like weddings and parties, they might say RSVP too, and they might place an email address, a name, or a telephone number. Because if it means please respond, it means that you're responding to somebody to indicate whether or not you will be attending, so that proper arrangements can be made for you. Am I talking to somebody? That's why whenever it comes on to important, expensive functions like weddings, you can't just make people show up so unless you own all of the goat them and the chicken them in a gray field. You have to make people RSVP. I remember some years ago, I went to participate in a wedding in Ocherius, Evangelist Bartley. And when I got to the wedding, everybody bush out and bash out in a red and white. And the wedding was one big wedding down at the hotel there in Ocherius. And when I got there, I saw people all over the place. But when it was time for the wedding reception, the hotel had set aside a room big enough for the number of guests that the couple had signed off on. Before the folks were through having cocktail, several persons were already inside the reception room. Reception room full, and half of the people them still outside. It was at this time that the groom acknowledged that several persons were at the wedding that he did not invite. And no doubt, he saw them long before the reception. But he must think of when you go to a dead yard, so everybody can come get a pot of this, a cup of this, and a plate of that. So when he recognized his dilemma, several of those who were invited guests were outside, and those who come catch and never got no invitation inside in a seat long time. One piece of frustration down at the hotel, because the man had nearly twice the number of guests that were invited. And hotels no skin teeth when it comes on to catering. In order to protect their bottom line, if you follow them, then count all the rice grain. The point of the matter is that if you tell them 50, them know how much rice serves 50, how much chicken serves 50, how much juice serves 50. Am I talking to the church here? And they might just provide a few extras. And anyway, stop shouting on. So this caused a problem. And while the groom and the bride were there in the lobby with the manager trying to figure it all out, the bride's brother stepped inside in a U.S. Army officer suit and asked, what's the problem? Why is the reception starting? And when they explained the problem, he took out a black card and said, what is it? Because the manager said, listen, if we are going to proceed, you can either send away the people who are not supposed to be in the reception or pay us the full amount for the difference and give us some extra time to cook more food. You're not hearing the preacher here. And when that's the man said, listen, whatever it is, I'll take care of it. And when the woman was like, sir, it is X amount, you know, the man just pop out the black card and said, whatever it is, handle it. Business handled. Take care. Just see, RSVP is important. It's a courteous request typically found in invitations, asking guests to confirm whether or not they will attend an event. Have you ever received one? The principles of RSVP revolve around etiquette, respect, clarity, organization, and consideration for both the host and the guest. And here are some key principles. You see, showing up at an event without an invitation is widely considered to be discourteous and can create numerous problems, both for the host and the uninvited guest. And some of these problems are disruption of planning. So when you plan for 50 and 100 come, no problem that and that a shame in the yayay. Come on, somebody. Limited resources. You have juice to run it for 20. But when you look, you see 40. How you going to manage? Half a glass each. Social awkwardness. You need to invite certain people. And when you're looking at the crowd, them did a stare and a skin teeth too. Come on, somebody. Safety and security and the lack of consideration. But my brothers and sisters, tonight, I want to let you know that there is a visitor who is planning to come to your event. The event of your life is going to come to your party. Some actually, this mic is chipping in and out. If you're going to change it now, because I was taxiing and now I'm about to take off. I said some of us have sent this visitor an invitation and the visitor is already RSVP, but some of you don't want the visitor at the party. Yes, sir. Juice it up now. Juice up the monitor. Some of us don't want this visitor to come over, but listen to the subject tonight. You did invite me, but I'm still coming over. You're not hearing the preacher here. The Bible opens up Daniel chapter 5. Belshazzar, the king, made a great feast for thousands of his lords. Let me tell you something. This tent could hold them, because 1,000 lords. Can you imagine a big man there in the place? When you look at that, the party there, if it were today, private jet just fly down at Ian Fleming's. You're not hearing the preacher here today. Helicopter land out of school pan the play field. You're not hearing the preacher here tonight. Big things are going, Benz and Bimmer, and all sort of Rolls Royce, rolling on the scene, and limousine, and everybody look nice and pristine, and he drank wine in the presence of the thousand. While he tasted the wine, he gave the command, the king of the wind thing, Elder Daniel, he gave the command, showing that he is the big boss, to bring the gold and silver vessels, which his father Nebuchadnezzar had taken from the temple, which had been in Jerusalem, that the king and his lords, more visitors did the man, more RSVP did they, his wives and his concubines, king of live life, might drink from them. Then they brought the gold vessels that had been taken from the temple of the house of God, which had been in Jerusalem, and the king and his lords, and his wives and his concubines, drank from them. They drank wine and praised the gods of gold and silver and bronze and iron and wood and stone. In other words, God wants to take away this kingdom, but I want him to know that we are responsible for all the gods. The head got a stone a few way, the silver got an arm and tie a few way, arm and breast a few way, the bronze got a thigh a few way, the iron got a legs a few way, and also the gods of the iron mixed with the clay a few way. Imagine, at first the Bible never even found it appalling, but when he sent for the vessels that they are taken out of the holy temple of the Lord's house in Jerusalem, in just cross the line, because you must understand that things that are sanctified for the Lord must be set apart for holy purpose. It was one thing that he had brought the holy vessels to Jerusalem, but to take the holy vessels into an unholy party, to be filled with rum and Red Bull, to pour into unholy vessels like his concubines and his many prostitutes and wives and his lords who were ungodly men, Syriac in the Lord's vessel, rum and Pepsi in the Lord's vessel, rum and boom in the Lord's vessel, brandy and water in the Lord's vessel, and they see him in the Lord's vessel, and they were having a good time. And when you went to that party, not any and anybody could go there. Security tall. You're not hearing the preacher. Security high. Soldiers were there. Police locked it down. Private secret service security details were all around. When men showed up, they had to show their RSVP, unless you were so close to the king that everybody already knew you. Lord of Master Lord was stepping into the yard and into the king's palace. Party shot like M16. When you look down, the beer confetti, beer fireworks, the best sound system they play down there, a mixture of Stone Love and Kilimanjaro, and all of them big sound there, a Ricky Trooper style and DJ Bambino, the best of artists gone down to Babylon, Be the Man and Bounty Killer and Chensia and Valiant, the whole of them depend there, every who is who wanted to be at the Babylonian party, and things down the arty, when you look at the girls down there, they're hot like Darby, you know, tell the preacher, they act like Barbie, they're hot like Barbie. No cheap woman can attend the party. If you drink out a gold cup, you can't wear plastic slippers. A be a Dolce Gabbana style. A be a Gucci down there. A Louis Vuitton then go put on. Shade a back pencil dress, 6-inch future pink stilettos. Contrasted with Aldo bags and Chanel clutch. And they never look so sus. No bump, no show up on face. L'Oreal hide all of the bump them. They cover it up like CIA, so it undercover. They not only look good, but they smell good. No granny, no couscous, no none of the party. A sender Issey Miyake, a Kim Kardashian, a Perry Ellis 360 degree, a Valentino down there, a Riri them in down there, and then the comedy party with no ordinary style. Some go get Brazilian butt lift for the party, some go put in more titty for the party, some go put in HBO for the party. Here belonging to others, no Remy Yakina down there, no premium yakina down there, a be a Peruvian, Brazilian frontal, a Malaysian, no one color here no down there, a copper sunset night, a ruby red day night, a cranberry kush day night, a curly curl, and crushed bread, they hop, all the eye them cover with awning, like them a shelter sun from the eyeballs them, a be a hotness down at the party, and music a play, and people a sweet, and them just a drink out of the vessel of the Lord, in defiance of the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. They were having coke and smoking, they were having a grand time, and they were just gallivanting. Oh, that they had the technology, they would be live on TikTok, they'd be live on Instagram, they'd be posting on WhatsApp, posting on Facebook, and sometimes you hear people cuss at Jamaica, say police lock off dance after midnight, but because it was the king's party, no police could lock it down, because Babylon was in charge, and if a government run the party, they can run it as long as them want. So they thought they had everything locked, but in the midst of the party, the Bible tells me, in the same hour, the fingers of a man's hand appeared and wrote opposite the lampstand on the plaster of the wall of the king's palace. If God had sent a man, they would have locked him out, because he never dip on the list, he never dip on the guest list, he never RSVP, so he could have sent Pastor JJ, because the way me big, they would have seen me. They could have sent Sister Maria, because it dressed so yellow, they would have seen her. They could have sent Evangelist Bartley, he went tall, they would have seen who that. So God said, me not send no foot, me not send no body, me not send no face, because face gives identity. I'm just gonna deal them a hand and send a hand, and the Bible says not just hand, it's the fingers of a man's hand, and he wrote on the wall. And when the king saw it, the Bible says in verse 6 that his countenance changed. The Roman Red Bull wear off, the Syriac wear off, the NSE wear off, so that the joints of his hips were loosened and his knees knocked against one another. All of a sudden, it will start knock me. Yeah, the thing say I scare appear at the party. I could rock steady, because if I rock steady, it will not take him time and a step so. But when God come to the party, you didn't invite me, but I'm coming over. He start rock like say I scare, because he was fretting and worried. He was horrified. When Jamaicans go out like them bad, they say, look here, you're not bad like my little finger. Yes, sir. But look on God's finger. The Bible says, let me tell you about the finger of God. Psalm 8:3-4 says, when I consider your heavens, the work of your fingers, the moon and the stars, which you have ordained, what is man that you are mindful of him? And the son of man that you visit him? Let us look at the finger of God. Exodus 31 verse 18. And when he had made an end of speaking with Moses on the Mount Sinai, he gave Moses 2 tablets of the testimony, tablets of stone written with what, somebody? The finger of God. Can I tell the church something? Whenever the finger of God shows up, it is a judgment. That is why God uses his finger to write the 10 commandments. Because if you're going to judge one law, if you know what kind of law you break. That's why the Bible says you must do no murder. So when you come in that judgment, you will have it to answer to. That's why the Bible says that you shall not steal. So when you scam and thief and chop a line, you have to answer to it. That's why the Bible says, honor your mother, your father. So when you treat your parents disrespectfully, you're going to answer to it. That's why the Bible says, thou shalt have no other gods before me. That's why when you put man in front of God, put job in front of God, put woman in front of God, put business in front of God, put sin and pleasure in front of God, you're going to answer in the judgment. And that's why the law says, remember the Sabbath day to keep it holy. 6 days shall you labor and do all your works, but the seventh day is the law, the Sabbath of the Lord your God. In it thou shalt not do any work. I'm not just talking to you. You can't be in a church and the shop still a run. You can't be in a church and the taxi still a run. You can't be a church and the farm still a run. 6 days you shall labor and do your work, but on the seventh day everything must lock down. But you're still gonna worship on Saturday. You're still gonna party this Saturday because you're gearing up for Easter weekend celebration. But when the finger of God shows up, it's a judgment scene. Oh, can I tell you more about the finger of God? In Luke chapter 11, Jesus says, but if I cast out demons with the finger of God, surely the kingdom of God has come upon you. You need to understand that in the kingdom of grace, the kingdom of God has come for you. But when you reject the call to salvation, at the kingdom of glory, the kingdom of God shall come upon you. Somebody not getting it. That's why in Revelation chapter 20, when the wicked dead are resurrected, the Bible says the kingdom will be what? Coming down, New Jerusalem with the righteous after the 1,000 years. What is it doing? Coming upon them. Somebody need to come to the kingdom before the kingdom come upon you. Because Jesus says, whosoever shall fall upon this rock shall have mercy and salvation. But if the rock ever falls on you, it's going to crush you. Man start shake. Proverbs 16:18 says, pride goes before destruction and a haughty spirit before a fall. You never hear the preacher? Pride goes before destruction and a haughty spirit before a fall. So every time you hear the call, or somebody just stands back because you're bad like Belshazzar. Every time you hear the call, and you just turn your back and go right into sin and say, nobody is going to run my life. Nobody can tell me when to give my life to God. Nobody can force me. Leave people and let them live their lives. We all have our own time. I'm going to wait until the Lord calls me. Tande. Pride goes before destruction and the haughty spirit before a fall. So watch verse 7 now. Somebody say, watch it. The king cried aloud, he holla. Knees are shaken by this time, I must deed up himself. In holla, bring in the astrologers, bring in the Chaldeans, bring in the soothsayers, in God for the God ring man them. In God for the island this and island that man them. All of a sudden, he sent Limo gone a center mass. He sent Benz gone up a more town. He sent taxi gone down a maroon town. He sent some of them gone all over in the Moneague District. You will be a man scattered all over the place now. He start shake. And the king spoke, saying to the wise men of Babylon, whoever reads this writing and tells me its interpretation shall be clothed with purple and have chain of gold around his neck and shall be the third ruler in the kingdom. The what, everybody? The third ruler in the kingdom. What is he saying? Lord have mercy. Can I preach it like I feel it? Now, Belshazzar was not the son of Nebuchadnezzar. But in those days, even your great, 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 almighty great grandfather would simply be referred to as your father. Or sometimes they would say our fathers to talk about your generations before, your genealogy, your lineage. Are we together? Nebuchadnezzar was the one that had to humble himself when he tried to defy the God of heaven. And then after that, now the king that was reigning was a man by the name of Nabonidus. But Nabonidus was of age, and they actually pulled off a coup d'etat to get a king out of the throne that was there before Nabonidus. And one of those who helped to pull off the coup was the same Belshazzar. So Belshazzar, because of his power and influence, positioned himself to take over after Nabonidus. But Nabonidus went into voluntary exile. No doubt he was intimidated or perhaps threatened. So who became the king? He became the king. So what he was saying, that hey, I am actually the regent, holding force until the king come back, knowing that Nabonidus would not return. So Nabonidus understand, I don't know, say I'm me next in line, may I go and reign right now, but I'm the acting king. But soon enough I'm going to be the king of kings. So anybody who interpret it is going to be next in line after me. He have people a line of feet and him not in the line no more. Hello somebody. Some of you have made plans for your assets, but when God cut you off, I'm not figure way. Hello somebody. So he started to make promises, and he says, now all the king's wise men came, but they could not read the writing. Then dash for the room all of a sudden. Some of them come seeing way with God wine glass, with God arm golden vest in their hand, and say, yeah. I wore that on the wall. I want that king. No man, a projector put it there under the aisle. So the Bible says they were greatly troubled. And listen to what the Bible tells us happens next. Come on somebody. You see, in the midst of the fun, the frivolity and the frolic, it is easy to forget, move on, the fickleness of life, and how easy it is for what? The tables to be turned to the cold pangs of death and misfortune. So the Bible said none of them could answer. So all of a sudden now, he sent for the queen. When the queen come in, remember, you know, the queen never mentioned at first, you know, a bear wives and concubines in there, but no queen come for rub down head. The queen, because of the words of the king and his lords, came to the banquet hall. Where was she before? Man no care woman got the dance, a bear schedule him down the way. Hello somebody. And she comes, oh king, live forever. Because she had to respect the king. Do not let your thoughts trouble you, nor let your countenance change. There is a man in your kingdom in whom is the spirit of the Holy God. Come on somebody in the church tonight. There's a man, and in the days of your father, light and understanding and wisdom like the wisdom of the gods were found in him. And King Nebuchadnezzar, your father the king, she a rub it in, you know, because God, wife vex, because I be me today at the dance. So wife vex, so wife a rub it in. Nebuchadnezzar, your father, made him chief of the magicians, astrologers, Chaldeans, and soothsayers. Are you seeing what's happening here, brethren? Listen, when Nebuchadnezzar found them 10 times wiser in chapter 1, him still never called them first in chapter 2. None at all. They had to volunteer. Because what? A lot of haters were there in Babylon. They hated the fact. So them look a foreign boy. You can imagine slave coming to your country and get leadership over you. And then never get the leadership because they're an obeah man. But the wisdom of God confounded them. Because the way God strong and wise and powerful. The Bible says even the foolishness of God is wiser than men. Come on somebody. So listen, when they invited the wise men to the party, they couldn't invite Daniel and his companions. Because them not drink crap. Them not drink liquor. And
them sure from chapter 1 said, none your mouth for the king table. You're not hearing the preacher here. When people are hosting events that do not align with your Christian principles, none yam from them. No drink from them. You're not hearing. No get quiet in the place. Some too wanga gut and some too wanga belly. Licky, licky and nyammy, nyammy. If you guard the dead yard, where you do a dead yard and a sound system appear down there. Once upon a time when you say dead yard, people come for pray and sing gospel song. Now a Kilimanjaro and stone love and all of the big sound them and bass are dizzy and dopey ban and these foolishness not nyam down there, not drink down there. Anywhere you go with them are food and the program is not according to your principles. Pray and fast and guard your yard fast. Yes. I say amen for you. Amen. Guard your yard fast. So the Bible said they never called Daniel, but they never wanted him there. Even if Daniel had attended such events before, they never wanted him there because they despised him and his God for going like they want to rule Babylon. Listen to me now, you're not done yet. The Bible says, inasmuch, verse 12, as an excellent spirit, knowledge, understanding, interpreting dreams, solving puzzles or riddles, explaining enigmas, were found in this Daniel, whom the king named Belteshazzar. Now let Daniel be called, and he will give the interpretation. You think the wise men, if Nebuchadnezzar had made him head over them, it means that after Nebuchadnezzar died, they revoked his headship.
What a word!
Hello?
Yes?
When Nebuchadnezzar died, they took away Daniel's position. Yes. But there's nothing lost when they take you from over the lead in them. So they knew that Daniel could do a 1, 2, 3 this for Daniel. So watch out now. They sent for Daniel. Right now the king no one hear no music. No Rihanna can't play. No Shabarangs can't play. No John Legend can't play. No Busta Rhymes can't play. You're not hearing me. No Joshi can't play. No Bujo can't play. Everything locked down. Sound system pass. Quietude in the place. Because the king has shake. He foot them just a knock like them will feel the car for one another. And the writing came on the wall. So when Daniel come in, I imagine the man of God stepped in and he stood before the king. And here they could face in this now. Listen, he made the same promise of gold chain and position and riches and purple robe to Daniel. Daniel said to the king, let your gifts be to yourself and give your rewards to another. You think you can buy salvation? The time is going to come that if you have a flying pastor, you don't fly him in. But pastor can't go flying because probation close. You're not trying to preach here. The time is going to come, you're going to be asking, where's Pastor JJ? Or any pastor? I need a pastor to baptize me. The Bible says, it done. Not go on. Let your gifts be to yourself and give your rewards to another. Yet I will read the writing to the king and make known to him the interpretation. Daniel came on business. Oh king, if the most high God, hear the history now, people. You can't miss it. You notice I took you from chapter 1 and brought you back to what Nebuchadnezzar had done and how we reached to this place, sister. Lo and behold, look how Daniel start the thesis. The Lord God, the most high God gave Nebuchadnezzar, your father, a kingdom and majesty, glory and honor. You remember the big tree? Come on now. In other words, every day you come out and talk about a few in Babylon. This, my daddy started this. And we are the rebels. And God here, daddy. And as much as that, but him, sister Sashai, he couldn't answer because he wanted the answer. So he said, give it to him. And because of the majesty that he gave him, all peoples, nations, and languages, it was the America of the day. That's why America in the Babylonian system of the end time. And feared before him. Whomever he wished, he executed. That's so imagine. Whomever he wished, he kept alive. Whomever he wished, he set up. Whomever he wished, he put down. Watch me now. But when his heart was lifted up, Nebuchadnezzar go on like him a ruler, and you have nobody else to answer to. And his spirit was hardened in pride. What did I say? What? Pride goes before what, church? Destruction. And a hearty spirit before a what? A fall. You notice what some people call themselves? Pride. Why did God cast Satan out of heaven according to Ezekiel and what? And Isaiah? Because of his what? Pride. So the pride people are showing you that they are satanic agents. The pride people are showing you that they don't care about God. Can I put it a little closer if I think I'm making it up? God gave the rainbow as a sign or symbol of the covenant promise to Noah that he would never again destroy the world with water. A fire come this time. So it was meant comfort. It was meant to be a comfort to those who suffered from the flood. That no worry yourself, no care hurry and afar. Our river come down. We now go wash out the whole world with a flood again. The pride people themselves, we will change that up. Color. Color. You hear the preacher here tonight? The pride people have aligned themselves with Satan. So when the Pope God tell us them no sanction same-sex marriage, I show you a Satan church that. I'm not talking while I couldn't hear what I want in this. When other churches across the world have signed off on same-sex marriage, they are showing you that they are agents of Satan. Pride caused Lucifer to be kicked out of heaven. That same Satan, the old serpent of old. And then call themselves what today? Pride. Because God said man to woman and woman to man. Pride said man to man, woman to woman. Left me to live a life. In some countries like Canada, them have them color sidewalk. And if you look upon them too hard, you're gonna walk out. But pride goes before a fall, and a heart before destruction, and a heart spirit before the fall. Amen. 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 Amen again. And amen again. Then the Bible says, he was driven from the sons of men because what? Pride came to his heart. He was deposed from his kingly throne, and they took his glory from him. So anytime you see the pride, you know say destruction will come. May I have to go a little further. In Sodom and Gomorrah, a be a proud people they down there. So when they come to Jamaica with the proud march them, anytime you see the pride matter start rise up, a judgment will come. Ask Sodom and Gomorrah. Lot offered the men virgin women. The woman, the man said, the man them were coming last night. We want the men that came in last night, never knowing that they were the angels of God. And they smote them with that blindness. And the man them out, they still a feel for the door because they want a little bottom in the night. Romans 1 said that. What? Giving up the natural use of the woman. So they create what? An amusement park in a waste management system. Hello. Notice, you know, anytime you build nothing, as a good master builder, you can't be like God. You must mark entrance and exit. The man never get no entrance but him out for yam food. And one exit. But the woman get entrance and she get exit. Lord have mercy. Hello, somebody.
Yes, sir.
So Nebuchadnezzar went and dwelt with donkeys, wild donkeys. They fed him with grass like oxen, and his body was wet with the dew of heaven. Till what? He knew that the Most High God rules in the kingdom of men and appoints it to whomever he chooses. Let me tell you, anything you're out there, whole lamp on, when God get rid of you, it's going to go to somebody else. You did a whole lamp on one man, and the man now one married, and you now let him come to Jesus. But you see, when God get rid of you, the man will go on to a next woman. Hello, somebody. You didn't know a whole lamp on woman, and woman doesn't want to settle down with you. But you see, when God takes you away, the woman gonna find one next man. You did a focus upon house and the one come to God. But when you're dead and gone, some God fight over the house. You're not here. The dead left and gone fight for her. You did a locked down car, locked down money. Because I say, look here, I am young. I got to floss. I gotta get rich this year. Next year can't pass. Because what? You're all about the money. But when God takes you down, the money you gonna share up. The money he's gonna share. So go further, Johnson. But you, his son Belshazzar, have not humbled your heart. See problem, your elder staple. You have not humbled your heart, although you knew all this. Me did I preach, but me I go teach little now. The queen came, giving all of this profile and introduction system at being of Daniel, as in to try and say, hey, I know you don't know this man. So your father had actually set him up, made him head of the magicians and the astrologers and the Chaldeans. Let me tell you, he has an excellent spirit in him, and he is very good at interpreting dreams and those things. Guess what? But the king had played a fool to catch wise. The king was a boy, he knew what God did to his father. A belly the king a carry against Daniel and Daniel God. But him forget said Daniel God surely will deliver. Amen. So hear this now. You king, Daniel said what? Knew all of this. Yes, so when judgment come, some go on like they never know the truth. They have never heard of the true and living God. But I see when the servant of God shows up, you knew all of this. And it goes further. And you have lifted up yourself against the Lord of heaven. They have brought the vessels of the house. You see what caused the last straw? Yeah, man. The vessels of the house before you, and you and your lords, your wives, and your skittles have drunk wine from them. And you have praised the gods of what? Silver, gold, bronze, iron, wood, stone, which do not see or hear or know. And the God who holds your breath in his hand and owns all your ways, you have not glorified. You see your life still? The God who holds the breath in your nostrils. We can't just go so any and go so and stick away. And him your pop style pan. And him your pop style pan. Every morning God give breath in a nostril. But you get up and sing Vibes Cartel. You get up and drink rum. You get up and wind up. You get up and go party. You give up and violate the commandments of God. But remember who have the breath. Remember who have the breath. You did glorify him. Then the fingers of the hand were sent from him. And this was the writing. See it you now. At this one here. And this is the inscription that was written. Come on, church. Mini, tickle, you frost him. This is in the it is the interpretation of each word. Mini, what is that, church? God has numbered your kingdom and finished it. School is over for the day. Done our work and done our play. It done. God has numbered your kingdom and finished it. One day God gonna count off your life. And because you're 30, and you think you're still young and hot, then you're gonna done at 30. And you knew that Jesus gonna say something like, she was just 30 years of age. R.I.P. Return if possible. Gone too soon. You put on life, anytime you're gone, you're gone. That's why the Bible says, seek ye the Lord while he may be found. Call upon him while he is near. Let the wicked forsake his way. And the unrighteous man is taught. And let him return to the Lord. You're planning for 40, you put on 40. You plan for your grandmother 70. You put on 70. The people are dying younger and younger, but the young people are getting more careless, notwithstanding. God has numbered your days. Weighed in the balance. This is a tickle. You have been weighed in the balances and found wanting. You know what that is? A symbol of judgment. You don't have no righteousness to balance it. Your life crooked and lopsided. You're not trying to preach. Perez, your kingdom has been divided and given to the Medes and Persians. Then Belshazzar gave the command, and they clothed Daniel with purple, thinking he can sweet up Daniel. And gold chain round him neck, because see how Daniel can then go dash them one side. And made a proclamation concerning him that he should be the third ruler in the kingdom. Third ruler after the end of the lineup. Go to the next verse now. The Bible says in verse 30, that very night, You remember after God sent the warning to Nebuchadnezzar, and Nebuchadnezzar got 12 months to repent. And when he was still too hearty, he said, "It's not this Babylon that I have built," that very moment. So this I want to know, the way I'm flopping God's face, God said, "Look here, this I want to now get no more time." Some of you are very hearty. Some of you are very full of yourself. You don't even have space for Jesus. But one day God is going to number your days. He's going to weigh you in the balance. You're going to be found wanting. And he's going to divide your what left, your dead left, and give it to other people. And that very day, the Bible says that very night, Belshazzar, king of the Chaldeans, was slain. And Darius the Mede received the kingdom, being about 62 years old. Young boy get kicked out, and old man take over. Hello, somebody. Same night, Isaiah chapter 13 prophesied about it. The burden of Babylon, against Babylon, which Isaiah the son of Amos saw, vision. Lift up a banner on the high mountain, raise your voice to them, wave your hand that they may enter the gates of the nobles. You see, Babylon's walls were considered impregnable. They were so wide that several chariots could ride on them side by side. Security guards, soldiers lived in those walls because they had rooms in them. So in order for you to get in, they had to roll up those strong, big metal gates. But in order for water to get into the city, guess what? The Euphrates was given access through gates. So it entered one side of the city through the water gates, which were kept locked, and then it exited on the other side so that water could come into the kingdom to take care of irrigating the crop and providing water for household purposes and for all the other reasons you use water for. So the Bible says God prophesied long before for his holy ones who were sanctified for the execution of the man of exaltation to enter through the water gates. So by divine providence that was spoken of long before in prophecy, the water gates them were open. So why them did they drink up the rum and drink up the Guinness and drink up the beer? The Medes and Persians were what? Breaching the water gates. Isaiah 45 also talked about it. Read it. Thus says the Lord to his anointed, to Cyrus, whose right hand I have held to subdue nations before him and loose the armor of kings, to open before him the double doors that are when he reach up into the kingdom now. So when Daniel did the attack, you see, by Daniel left the scene, the doors them just go so whoosh. The gates will not be shut. Amen. Look at what God had prophesied about Babylon's fall. So the gates will not be shut. I will go before you and make the crooked places straight. And who going to go right, Paniwa? God himself. And I will give you the treasures of darkness and hidden riches of the secret places, that you may know that I, the Lord, who call you by your name, am the God of Israel. God prophesied it. But watch me now, Church of God. The same thing that befell Belshazzar is going to befall many of us because of the stubbornness of our heart. First Thessalonians tells us, but concerning the times and the seasons, brethren, you do not need that I should write to you. For you yourselves know perfectly that the day of the Lord comes as a thief in the night. For when they shall say what? Peace and safety, then sudden destruction comes upon them as labor pains upon a pregnant woman, and they shall not escape. The handwriting has been upon the wall, but nobody wants to listen. If we have a big party here this Easter Monday and bring in the chensia and the spice and the butcher and the beanie and the valley, and let me tell you, money locked down, a beer, car and truck and van and bus, walk, foot and bicycle. Me say money not good again. My road lock off, Scotty lock off, Gibraltar lock off, Crossroad lock off, Bacabush lock off, Friendship coming down lock off, the whole of money lock off. But when you're called to Jesus, nobody wants to come. You notice all the party, they full of lords? Yes, man. The handwriting has been on the wall. God has given us the handwriting of the last day signs, and I've been saying them to you. He talked about the earthquakes, and we've seen them just last year, February, the Turkey-Syria earthquake. Over 50,000 people died, over 100,000 people injured, and millions were misplaced. Can I talk to somebody here? Millions of them were displaced, and not only so, it gets worse than that. Las Colinas, January 13, 2001, massive earthquake and landslide. Several people died. You thought that Kingston and Port Royal was anything in 1907? And I'm going to go. I come to come. The Bible says the handwriting is on the wall. The Arctic region is currently melting away. You call it global warming. The Bible says signs in the sun. We talk about that Indonesian tsunami in 2008. Over 250,000 people died. We talk about that tsunami in Tohoku, Japan in 2011. Over 20,000 people died. World War I, 37 million. World War II, over 60 million. But the Bible tells me that whenever I see these things, I must not get comfortable. It's not time for partying. It's time for repentance. For Luke 21, 25 says, and there will be signs in the sun. I said that the handwriting is on the wall. Signs in the sun. You don't feel the heat of Jamaica. And in the moon and in the stars. And on the earth, distress of nations. Look at Russia. Look at Ukraine. Look at the Palestine. Look at the wars with perplexity. The sea and the waves roaring. Men's heart failing them from fear and the expectation of those things which are coming on the earth. For the powers of heaven will be shaken. Then they will see the Son of Man coming in a cloud with great power and glory. So the Bible says, now when you see these things, lift up your head, the next one, and look up, for your redemption draw it nigh. And so Jesus said, look up the fig tree, look up the trees. When they are already budding, you know that you yourselves know that summer is near. So you also, when you see these things happening, know that the kingdom of God is near. Now is not the time for you to rebel. Colossians 3 verse 2, come on now, says, set your affection on things above and not on things on the earth. Lift up your head, oh ye gates. It's time for you to focus on the coming of the Lord. The handwriting is on the wall. Therefore, put to death your members which are on the earth. Fornication, uncleanness, passion, evil desire, covetousness, which is idolatry. Because of these things, the wrath of God is coming upon the sons of disobedience. Second Peter tells us, but the heavens and the earth, which are now preserved by the same word, are reserved for the fire until the day of judgment and perdition of ungodly men. And the day of the Lord will come as a what, everybody? A thief in the night, in which the heavens will pass away with a great noise, and the elements will melt with fervent heat. Both the earth and the works that are in it will be burned up. You see, after all of these things, Daniel received visions of the end. And when he never understood them in chapter 12, listen what God said to him. But you, Daniel, shut up the words and seal the book until the what? Time of the end. Many shall run to and fro, and knowledge shall increase. But listen, which time are we in now? When did God tell Daniel that the book shall be shut up until the time of the end? Go to the last chapter of Revelation, written in AD 95. And he said to me, verse 10, do not seal the words of the prophecy of this book, for the time is at hand. You see the handwriting, everybody? God told Daniel, Daniel, stop stressing over this. This is end time matter. Lock it up, because the Old Testament is prophecy concealed to a degree, and the New Testament is prophecy revealed. So in the book of Daniel, many of these end time signs were considered for the time of the end. So God said, lock up your book. But listen to what God says to John, the last Bible one. He said, open up the book. Why is it important? Because it's end time. And you see, when God draws the line, like Belshazzar, the handwriting will be on the wall. And listen what the Bible says. Read it as I get ready for my appeal. He who is unjust Let him be unjust still. You see, some are of the opinion say, I'm not coming in this crusade, but I have time. I know that I need to get baptized, but I have time. I want to do it, but I can't do it now. I'm too young. I need to enjoy life a little more. I have time. But you see, when the final handwriting comes on the wall, probation will be closed. And you see, when God draw the line, he who is unjust, let him be unjust still. He who is filthy, let him be what? Filthy still. But look, rough man, but look at the next side. He who is righteous, let him be righteous still. He who is holy, let him be holy still. You hear what is going to happen? What is God saying? Any side you are on that day, you will have to remain till the end. And God says, look here, I am coming quickly, and my reward is with me to give everyone according to his work. Everybody here will receive a reward. No matter how you're bad, reward did they feel. But can you handle it? Tonight, I'm going to make a twofold appeal. The handwriting of the coming of the Lord has been on the wall of the signs of times, And soon enough, the last events will happen and Jesus will come. Will you stand boldly like Daniel, or will you shake and wobble like Belshazzar? When the Lord comes to judge the world, all those who want to be on the righteous side, please come up to this altar. Come. All those who want to be on the righteous side, please come up to the altar. Those who don't, stay. All those who want to be on the righteous side, come up to the altar. I will tell you when to start singing, Sister Molly. All those who want to be on the righteous side online, type the letter R for righteous in the chat. All 2.5 thousand of you, write it. Don't play the music yet. I'll tell you when to start. I say, all who want to be on the righteous side, come to the altar. I'm not calling the ungodly tonight. I'm calling those who want to be on the righteous side. Come to the altar. All those who want to be there on the righteous side in the chat, type R. If you are here tonight and you have not yet surrendered your life to Jesus, that is a hindrance. It means that if you remain like that, when the handwriting is written, you will be weighed in the balance and found what? Wanting, because you have not been leveled by God. If you have not yet given your heart to Jesus, step into the front. We want to pray for you tonight. You came because you want to be on the righteous side. If you have not yet surrendered your heart to Jesus, step into the front. Come. Don't dry your foot, people. Step out boldly for the Lord. Come, step right here. Come. I want to pray for you. If you have not yet surrendered your life to Jesus, you step into the front. Yes, my sister. Step into the front. Nobody has to pick you out for you, you know. You know where you stand. You know your truth. You know your heart. If you are not yet a Christian, come to the front. If you are a backslider, that doesn't count for anything. Come to the front. Remember how Nebuchadnezzar acted as if he never knew God? But Daniel said to him, you, Belshazzar, knew all of this, but you did not humble yourself. Pride goes before destruction, and a heart is spirit before a fall. Praise the Lord. Come, waiting for you. All of those who are here tonight who have not yet been baptized, come to the front. All those who are here but you are backsliders, come to the front. Those who are here but you are Christians who have been violating the commandments, come to the front. It's up to you. You cannot come this far to say you want to be on the righteous side and you still catch up out of the side. Step in. Because let me tell you, you see, whether you're ready or not, my Jesus is coming. Amen. You did not invite me, but I'm coming over. Belshazzar never invited God, nor God's children to the party, but God showed up anyway. Come on, somebody. God is getting ready to crash somebody's party, to mash up somebody's dollhouse. But you have a time to repent. You have a moment to repent. If you are not yet a Christian, we want to pray for you. Come over here, right here. Come on, you know yourselves. If you once walked with the Lord, but you lost your way, but you want to say, Pastor,
I want to do right by God for my own sake. Come. Praise the Lord, young man. Come. Come, folks. Don't be afraid. Don't let the same pride that caused Belshazzar's destruction to come to you. Those who are online, people are typing the R. But if you have not yet surrendered your life to Jesus, typing the R will not take you far. You have to repent and turn from your sins in order to be saved. How do you become righteous? Go to the next slide, tech team. Go to the next slide. Mark 16, verse 16. Come on, church of God, read with me here. He who believes and is baptized shall be saved. Question to you, saved from what? Saved from what? Line up to pray, Evangelist Bartley, after the song. Sing the song now, Sister Molly. Saved from destruction.
You have longed for sweet peace.
All those who have not yet received the Lord, come.
And for faith.
Stand at the front as a sign of your intention to be on the Lord's side. Come.
You have earnest.
Come.
Live firm.
Come.
Pray. Come.
Sing that song. Come.
You see, but you can't.
Come. There are others here who need to step out. Help somebody to step into this service. You know who you are. You know who you are. Come. Backsliding man and woman, come.
Till you
sinner man, come. Come.
Your
disobedient, come. Come and take your staff.
And so. I said you have longed.
Sing that song.
For sweet peace.
That's right.
And for faith to increase.
Come.
You have earnestly fervently prayed. Yes, Lord.
God is waiting on somebody else to come. Come. Come right in the front.
Not be blessed.
Don't hide at the back. Step forward.
Or of peace.
Come, yes. Praise the Lord.
Sweet
come. You know yourselves. Come.
Till you healed him, your body.
All 2,600 people online. Those who are not yet in the Lord. Come.
Sacrifice. Come.
This is a serious call. A life and death moment. Choosing the Lord while he may be found. And call
and
upon him while he's there. Before you sing further, now brothers and sisters, do you see the big challenge that's posed there? Notwithstanding these very clear, real biblical experiences of others who rejected God, many continue to reject God. Notwithstanding these clear-cut messages, many still believe they can work around God's system. But tonight, each must decide his own fate. You can decide to fall in judgment like Belshazzar, or to stand in righteousness like Daniel. You might believe that you can walk away tonight and just say to God in your heart, God, you know that I never went, but I love you. Nicodemus came by night because he never wanted his friends and colleagues to see him. God doesn't want any undercover love. He says, if you do not confess me before men, I will not confess you before my Father. If you confess me before men, I will confess you before my Father. So don't think you can simply say in your heart, God, you know where my heart is. Come and show where your heart is tonight. If you're on the Lord's side, come over here. You know yourself. Backslider, I invite you to come to the altar. Step into the front. Unrepentant sinner, I invite you to come in this circle at the front. You may be a worshiper,
but you have not been worshiping in the truth. You've been rejecting the Lord's Sabbath and other teachings that are plainly taught in the Bible. Come to the front. Who else will come? Sing that song. God is marking the actions tonight.
As Jesus said, come.
Come.
To the water.
And stand by my side.
And stand by my side.
Drink from the fountain.
He says, drink from the fountain. You won't be denied.
For he has seen. For
he says, he sees.
Every teacher. To the water.
To the water.
And stand.
And stand by my side.
He says drink.
He says drink.
We're waiting for somebody else to come. It's the last night. It's the last call. It's the last opportunity.
He says I've seen.
Every teardrop. Waiting for somebody else to step out before Sabbath, which is the last baptism. This is the last night call. Somebody needs to step out. God never sent you this message for you to stay comfortably in your sin. If you are not baptized tonight, come. If you are a backslider tonight, come. If you are walking partially in God's commandments, come. This is your opportunity to repent. Come to the Lord. Come to the Lord. The Lord is waiting for somebody else. We're going to change that song and we are going to wrap it up shortly. The song says, I was so empty, I needed someone who could take away this emptiness inside. Hallelujah. I turned away when my friends would tell me I should come to you and surrender all my life. My life was restless till I obeyed them.
Yes, I obeyed them.
I find the church that I could go to set me free. Come to the altar, somebody. It was at the altar.
It was at the altar.
I cried, Lord, save me.
Lord, save me.
I felt the burden slowly lifting off my life. Want to come to the altar? Hear me now. My life was lost without you.
Lost without you.
Every time I think I'm better, I get worse. Dear Jesus.
Yes, Jesus.
I need your help, Lord.
I need your help, to come. Lord.
Don't you ever turn away.
Don't turn
and let
away,
me
Lord.
Fall. Hear the last verse now, I say right now. All I have.
All I have, yeah.
Is only you.
It's only you, Lord.
Every friend I turn to always let me down.
They let me down.
I remember you promise.
I remember you promise, yeah.
To never leave me.
Never
to come.
Leave me.
I'm depending on
yes,
you, Lord,
Lord,
to hear my call. If you truly love the Lord, sing the chorus. Lord, I love you. Lord, I need you. In the middle of the night,
Lord,
I need you in the middle of the night. I was so lost without you.
No, you never. leave me.
Never leave me.
I say you're the one.
You're the one.
You never leave me.
Somebody else, listen to this one now.
Oh, yeah. Oh.
Sometimes I cry for your help.
I cry, Lord.
When I have temptation knocking at my door.
Right at my door.
Oh, how I wonder.
Oh, I wonder, Lord.
Where are you, Lord?
Where are you, Lord?
When the devil seems to knock me on the floor. Lord, sing it tonight.
Lord, I need
come to the Lord if you love him tonight. Come
Lord,
to the Lord if you trust him tonight.
You in the middle of the night.
I was lost without you.
Lost without you.
No, you never leave me.
Never leave me.
You're the one.
You're the one to fix the things that aren't right.
Yes, you're the name of Jesus.
Praise him.
God has spoken. Let the church say
amen.
Amen. Tonight, you have made your decision. And the choice you have made and how you will follow through on that choice will determine which side you will be on. When God says it is finished, let him that is filthy stay filthy still. Just as how Daniel reminded Belshazzar that he was playing fool to catch wise because he knew about all these things. When this time of judgment comes, many of us will act as if we never knew better, so we didn't do better. But God will remind you that tonight happened. God will remind you that tonight happened. And not just tonight, but every other occasion that you had an opportunity to repent and you chose to remain in your sins. Evangelist Martin.
My spirit is troubled tonight as I reflect and a few weeks ago, this tent was in Ocherius on the Buckfield playfield, and the team went to a particular home in Beecher Town, and they studied and plead with a young woman, encouraging her to surrender her life to God. And she told the brethren that they are filing for her, and because of this, she can't surrender her life to the Lord now. The team prayed with her and left. It was the final Thursday night. The final Thursday night of the campaign.
Yes.
The call came that she died suddenly. The final Thursday night. This is the final Thursday night. Same tent. Same message. Messages. And God is calling on somebody tonight. We don't know what will happen, but what a night it is for somebody to say, all to Jesus, I surrender. Pastor, I feel like I want to give somebody else the opportunity.
Give the opportunity, preacher.
Pass me not, O gentle Savior.
Give that opportunity.
Hear my humble cry.
Mm-hmm.
You are in the hearing of my voice. You have not yet surrendered to Jesus. I want you to demonstrate an act of faith.
Yes.
By walking from where you are and join me on the platform. Higher ground. You have been coming to this location for a long while, but God is calling you to come up higher tonight. And I'm asking somebody, disappoint the devil tonight. Step on higher ground tonight. Give God an opportunity in your life. Is there one tonight? Step from where you are. Join me on the platform here.
Do not pass me by.
Is there one tonight?
Not pass me.
Is there one tonight?
I'm singing.
Disappoint the enemy tonight. Give God the victory.
Is there one?
Lord,
is there one tonight?
Hear my humble cry. I say, why on others thou art called?
Do not pass me by.
Is there somebody on the outside?
Not pass.
Is there somebody that's watching online? Is there somebody that's on the inside? Savior, Savior.
Let me at
I say, Savior.
The final night.
Savior.
The final night.
Oh, hereby.
This could very well be your last opportunity. Is there one tonight? Do not pass me by.
Pass
you may be on the outside.
By.
You may be on the outside. Is there one tonight? Is there one tonight? As we draw the curtains down, is there one tonight? You may be online tonight, not yet surrender to Jesus. Tonight you want to say, preacher, I want to be baptized this coming Sabbath. Type B in the chat. Wherever you are, we can hook you up with a Seventh-day Adventist church. Really. 30 seconds and I will pray. Is there one tonight? Is there one tonight? Mm-hmm. gracious Father, we're thankful tonight for the preaching of the gospel. We're thankful, Lord, for the plan of salvation and for the saving of souls. We bless your name, O God. Indeed, you are worthy to be praised. From the rising of the sun until the going down of the same, you are worthy. Tonight, O God, we just want to exalt your name. We magnify your name. We lift you up, O God, because you are God and there is none like you. I pray tonight that you will draw divinely close to this spot. I ask God that you will visit every worshiper under this tent tonight. Move mightily in this place, God, from person to person, from cheer to cheer. Rescue the perishing, care for the dying, snatch somebody in pity from sin and the grave. Oh God, tonight I recognize that the hand of the enemy has laid hold on your children. Oh God, it has been 4 weeks since your name have been lifted up at this place. It has been 4 weeks, oh God, since the preaching of the gospel have been going forth in this community. It has been 4 weeks, God, you have been calling men and women to surrender their lives to you. But God, as your words tells us, that light has come into this world, but people would rather darkness than light because their deeds are evil. I pray tonight in the name of Jesus that you will come through tonight, God, for somebody. Fight some battles, battle tonight. I pray, Holy Ghost, that you will visit this altar tonight and that you will speak to the hearts of your people. Lord. Oh, divine God, tonight I pray that you will break some chains tonight. I ask in the name of Jesus that you will fly some fetters tonight. I ask, Holy Ghost, that you will move in this place tonight. Deliver somebody, rescue somebody, save somebody tonight, Jesus. Oh God, there is somebody at the altar who know that they need to surrender their lives to you, God. But tonight, Jesus, there is a situation that surrounds them. You are God, and tonight I pray, deliverer, that you will deliver such person from this bondage tonight, and that you will set the captives free. Oh, divine God, there is a lady in a relationship. She wants to surrender, oh God, but the partner is not willing to move tonight. I pray, Holy Ghost, that you will visit such an individual wherever he is right now. I ask Jesus that you will speak to his heart. Help Jesus to understand that they have a heaven to gain and a hell to shun. Oh God, whatever the circumstances tonight, I pray that you will disrupt and that you will interrupt every plan from hell, spirit of the living God. We declare war tonight against the kingdom of darkness. I pray, divine God, that you will break down every idol, cast out every foe. We are on the brink of eternity. Somebody is playing with their salvation. I pray, divine God, that this spot will be a witness against somebody. And even when the tent comes down, every time that they pass this spot, somebody will remember, God, that salvation has come to Cryerfield. Every time that they remember the spot, they will hear the voice of the preacher. They will hear the Holy Ghost calling, "This is the way, walk ye in it." I pray, God, that good sense will prevail, and that before time changes into eternity, that somebody will muster the courage to surrender to Jesus. Oh God, I pray that you will visit those who are worshiped online. I pray that you will seal their decision, not just for time, but for eternity. Bless those in your turn. I pray, God, that your words will not return unto you void, but that it will accomplish that which it must. Bless every member of this district. Bless your manservant. And I pray, God, that as the final message is prepared for this spot, that, God, a word will be said that will turn this community upside down. And that men and women will run into the community and they will cry out, "Come, see a man." And that, God, heaven will be populated because of the conclusion of this series. It is with thanksgiving I humbly ask, in Jesus' name, amen. Amen.
Amen. Thank you, evangelist. Before you leave, this Sabbath is our final baptism. You can change your life by exercising faith in Jesus Christ. Pack your things. Come out this Saturday at 9 a.m. Join us for worship and make a full surrender to the Lord Jesus Christ. We look forward. We look forward to seeing you all this Sabbath. Remember to walk with your water. It's going to be hot. And your food, as we worship the beauty of holiness. For those online, help somebody to get this message even afterwards by giving the thumbs up if you have not yet done so. Go ahead and subscribe if you are new. And remember to go back to the stream afterwards and make a comment about tonight's message. God bless you. I'll count you down to do that thumbs up. 3, 2, 1. See you this Saturday. No bandula business. At 9 a.m. with our Sabbath school and the message in the divine service closer to midday. And if you want to give your heart to Jesus, make sure that you have filled out that card so we can touch base with you. Our host will now come to take us out.
Just a few now. You didn't invite me, but I am coming over. I am happy to know that despite whatever it is, and we might not have invited God, He will be entering into our lives. And when He do so, it will always be a blessing, Sister Fiona. The door is about to be closed. The proclamation train is leaving this spot of ground. Brothers and sisters, the warning has been given. Get it right and secure yourself in Jesus before the last message is preached, which will be this Sabbath coming.
That is right, my sister. Indeed, the message is soon to be preached. Tonight, we did not invite him, but he came over.
Yes.
What a word of warning. We don't have the luxury of time, right? Don't be like Belteshazzar, or Nebuchadnezzar tonight.
Yes.
According to Jenny Bennett in the chat, she said, we must take heed. God is in charge. Remember, He will and can lock down your life.
Amen.
So brothers and sisters, take heed.
Yes, and as Pastor Johnson said, when God draws the line, we cannot cross it.
Cannot cross it at all.
Yeah.
Tonight we had over 2.4, I think it went up to 2.6.
Yes.
Right. So those were the number of devices that we had online tonight. Not the number of persons though, because we know that there are persons. Right. And I am going to say big ups to Kirk and Shelley and Sterling and Marie Carnegie, Sophia Collins, Janet Johnson Palmer, Kenneth Brown, Juanita Bailey, Norma Williamson, Jennifer Lewis, Elaine Wallace. And the last message I saw that I looked at came from Chantel Carter Edwards, and she said, I am sad that this is the last night.
Can you imagine?
Keep up the good work, Pastor JJ, and I pray that God will keep on blessing you, and you will keep on blessing others
indeed,
with the word.
Indeed. Hear what Kadeen White said. I really enjoy this series. I am not a Sabbath keeper, but the word of God was preaching. I take every bit of it. Thanks for the word.
Amen.
Yes.
Amen. Amen. All right. So we continue to keep our dedicated families in prayer. And remember, wherever Moneague Online is having any program, we ask that you tune in and join us. We want to wish for each and every one of you tonight a wonderful night. Enjoy the rest tomorrow night as you make preparations for Sabbath, when it will be the final proclamation. And that's proclamation number 20. And
no bandulu business. Yes.
So, on behalf of the Proclamations of Hope series, I am Fiona Wallace Graham.
And I am Samantha Suka Douglas.
Wishing you all good night.
Good night.
Good night.